Welcome back from that quick break. We're still here on Urban Television, one-on-one, but exclusively Woman Crush Wednesday with the most beautiful. With an upcoming artist. Her name is Julz. And yeah, thank you very much for coming to the studio, by the way. Because, you know, one thing that we never talk about is these people also have a hard time. This business, you need to sit and wait sometimes. Anisha is, you know.
Yeah,
she's been here for about an hour, by the way. So thank you very much, Julz.
Welcome.
Now let's get into. I want to call you the myth buster, because I want you to bust all the myths that we have in this industry.
Oh my days.
You know, so many times artists are hesitant, especially when they're still, you know, young in the industry. They're hesitant when it comes to making collaborations.
Mm-hmm.
I want to know why, because in our head we feel like collaborations help you bust out and become big in the industry. For example, if you've seen Sheba Karungi and
are you talking about Eve?
Not Eve. Come on, I'm going to guess again. Another big artist who did a collaboration, Farmer.
Yeah,
Waikibenda. Yes, yeah. Waikibenda and Sheba Karungi.
Yeah.
After they did Farmer, Waikibenda blew out. So people believe that collaboration. What?
Yeah, helped him. Yeah.
But why is it that people are not doing so many collabs these days?
I think I would say collaborations are. I think I'm gonna say it's by luck.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, if you do a collab with someone who is big, for me, I swear, if I wanted to do a collab with anyone, it would be someone who is way, 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 way too big. I'm not saying like Ugandan artists, but then when you do a collab with people here, they take most of the credit. And your song, and most of the times this is your song, you paid for the video, you've done all these things, but then you're not recognized. It's the artist that featured in your video or your song that takes the credit. So it puts you down and down and down. For some people it's lucky, like Waikibenda. Mm. He was lucky. And after that he started making some good songs after that.
Mm.
But then I know some artists who have done collabs with big artists and they're nowhere.
Mm.
You know, and every single time this artist goes on stage, she or he still sings the songs.
Song.
And this person can't sing the songs anymore. You get, so it's really, really hard. And I think,
but that's sad, because if you think about it, I feel that the bigger artists should be the ones who not fitting all the beats, but it can be like, hey, okay, let me pay for studio session, because that is what we need. We need people to uplift each other.
True.
You know. But you can't make the younger artist pay for the song, the studio session, the video, and then you take credit. Because obviously people know you more.
Yeah, that's a bad thing with collaborators.
So now you're a mother. Let's get into that. How do you juggle the fact that you are a mother and then you also have this nightlife that you have to have?
Oh, it's not easy. It's hard. It's really, really hard, because you have to, that means you have to, like, most of the time you have to be home, and then you have to take your son to, you know, playtime, you have to be with your son. Because every single time leaving home and you're leaving him crying, you're like, oh my God, he's too young and stuff like that. So it's hard, but then along the way I have a feeling it's gonna get better.
You're such a positive person, by the way. You're very, very, very positive. I'm also a single mom, and you're a single mom, but also it's becoming an epidemic for us. Tuli banj at such a young age. I think that is that the reason as to why you're motivated?
Yeah, I'm motivated, and I think I'm stronger right now, because, I mean, at first I was like, oh my God, how am I going to do this and stuff like that? How can I be a single mother? You know, it's hard because no one wants to be a single mother.
Yeah.
But it just happens. But when it does, you're like, you know what? I have to do this for my son. Every single time I leave home, I'm like, you know what? I'm doing this for you, so that he knows that I'm doing this for you. And when he sees me on TV and I go back home, he's like, mommy, I saw you on TV. And I feel so happy, because he knows at least I'm somewhere, like, I'm on TV, not somewhere doing drugs or, you know, doing something dirty and stuff like that. But at least he knows, oh my God, every single time I'm leaving home, he's like, mommy, are you going on TV? Because that's what he thinks.
Mm.
And it's really, really nice. It's
beautiful. Yeah. Speaking of the fact that we talked about sex and in the industry, but also there's a rising drug intake.
Yeah.
It's rising. And so many youngins are being pressured into it. Is it also because of the fact that you have a child that for you can't be misled into that world?
Even before,
because
I
had people like Jackie Chandiru, who was
oh yeah,
she was brilliant.
I
she
know.
Had the one of the best vocals Yeah. But look at her now.
I know, yeah.
You get it. So how do you say no? I'm sorry, I'm not gonna sniff that. I'm not gonna sniff any of that.
No, I think every person, not even artists only, I think every person should have their own principles. You're like, you know what, I can't do this. I won't do this because I've had friends who smoke and drink and do, but then you're like, no. And they tell you, no, take a, you know, they try to tell you, it's just, you know, but then you're like, no, I don't do that. I mean, that is me. I just don't do, it's not me. And even before I had a child, I never used to do such a thing. Mm. I mean, maybe you could drink and stuff, but when it comes to drugs, that is something like crazy. Mm. And now that I have a child, every single time I think about it, I'm like,
what if my child did?
Yes, I wouldn't want my child to grow up on drugs. Oh my God, I would even cry. Mm. I mean, it's not something that everyone wants to do. Mm. But then some people are so weak. I mean, when they have so many friends doing it, they easily join. But then you have to stand your ground and be like, I will not do this. That's it.
Now let's head into the social media platforms that you're probably working on. How is your Instagram, your Facebook? What are the names you're using? Do you push things there? New projects that you're working on?
Yeah, I do. My Instagram handle is julzmusic_official. Same on Twitter. And then Facebook is Julz.
Yeah. And by the way, the funniest thing is, now I've just remembered it. Is Julz your birth name? Because you know, eh? Mm. Is Julz your birth name? You know, you could be a Nakawunde Esther.
Like, oh my God, like, yeah. Julz is a short form of Juliana.
Juliana.
Yes, mm-hmm. So it's Julz, but with a Z at the end.
Okay.
Yeah, and then my real Chiganda name or son name is Kajumba. I'm a Munyoro.
Oh, that's beautiful. Yeah. That's beautiful. Projects that you're working on?
Yeah, I have projects coming out anytime soon. And I have a single which will be dropping anytime soon. That will be like in October. Mm. And yeah, people will love it, I think.
We pray.
Yeah, you know? I pray they do.
Like,
I pray
before they do. We're going to ask, how do you know a song is going to work out? Because that's the hardest thing. They write like 4, I don't know. Then you have to pick like Neda in UGANDA Kola. It's so hard.
It's so hard. How I picked songs, I imagine myself like you would listen to any song. Yeah, like they give you like 4 songs. That's how I imagine picking a song. So I'm like, okay, I'm in the club or I'm anywhere, and this is not my song. I imagine like it's someone else's song. So I'm like, you know what? Let me see how it is. So if I feel the vibe and I'm like, I'm liking it, I'm grooving to it, I'm like, you know what? This is gonna work. And I have a team, an amazing team, which is Cup's team. Mm. We listen to the song like in studio. Like if there's a song, we are there as a team.
But that's one thing Ugandans have failed to understand, management.
Yeah.
And I think that is beautiful, the fact that you're a young artist and that you've quickly joined a management. You need a team. You know, you need someone to help you, not only financially, we've talked about finances, but also someone who's going to help you, Julz, in dress code, in terms of, no, that doesn't work for you.
True,
that is a big thing.
Yeah, true.
Man, your industry is hard.
I know, it's really, really hard. When people see you out, they think, oh my God, you're so easy, but it's hard.
So, in actresses, Binevia Slay Queen, it's okay to be Tay. You're not a slay queen. You're out there trying to make good music and inspire people, right?
Yeah, true.
Oh, that's lovely. Thank you very much for coming around and waiting and being part of the show. By the way, she was on Double Trouble. Weren't you on Double Trouble?
Yeah, I was.
Keep pushing for Julz music. Go on her social media pages. Watch out for her single that might be coming out in October. I'll be pressuring you to come back here and premiere it.
True, I'll be coming here.
Thank you very much, Cozy African Entertainment, for, you know, pushing her. And we need more management. We need, you know, that's one thing the country is lacking.
Yeah,
the music industry. We need more managers, marketeers in the music industry. We only have them for banks.
Yeah, I think every artist needs a manager because you need someone to tell you what not to do, because there's so many things you do and then you're told, oh, you're not supposed to do that.
Yeah.
Oh, you're not supposed to do that. And then you don't know you're not supposed to do that. And then they, and still with the music, well, when you ask me about picking the song, at times you pick a song, but when you sit as a team, they tell you, they give you ideas.
Yes.
They are critics. They're like, no, this song is not going to work. Mm. So it's really good to have a management.
Yeah. Thank you very much again. Now it's about that time we sign up. Thank you very much for being our Woman Crush Wednesday. That is all we had for you. My name is Anisha Mediti. Head out to my social media pages. Anisha everywhere. A-N-I-T-S-H-A. Mirembe is my second name. That is my birth certificate, by the way.
Mm.
There's Anisha with us. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.